are cleaning their garbage disposal with ice. You're supposed to like really, really push the ice into the garbage disposal and like fill it up. So let me get more ice. Poor mother. Definitely think that I did this wrong. Okay, we got a bunch more ice. I don't get it. I don't know why it's not working. I just consulted the TikTok comment section and they say that we should use cold water. A lot of ice, a little bit of cold water. Here it comes! It's working! Oh, this is so gross! Oh my gosh! Ew! I gotta throw away this spoon.
Come watch as I deep clean my Bissell Crosswave. Alright y'all, I have been doing this since I got my first apartment. You can get these scrub brushes at the dollar store, fill it up with Dawn dish soap and vinegar. When you're in the shower, just scrub here and there or anywhere you see dirty and you will never have to deep clean again.
Hi, my name is Tara Nelly. I'm a professional deep cleaner. I started this business in Savannah, Georgia 11 years ago when I was 22 years old. I started out cold calling customers, doing Groupon ads, and marketing in every possible way. After a year, our business was booming, and we expanded to new cities. What made us most successful is our accountability, attention to detail, and being absolutely in love with the work we do. My advice for anyone starting out, work hard every day and give it all you've got, and don't forget to have a blast.
Thank you. Okay guys, I'm just going to be doing a really quick tidy up of our family bathroom. My husband likes to leave his clothes right next to the laundry, which I love. I'm going to clean the boys' little toilet seat and then just get rid of some bits before doing the much dreaded washing up in the bath. Get rid of the clean stuff downstairs and then clean up the bath afterwards because, you know, who wants to have a bath in stuff that has food on? I'm going to just give a little general tidy up. I mean, that's pretty much what this is anyway. Put the bath toys away. Move things back where they're supposed to go. Yes, we have squash in the bathroom because there's no running water downstairs. All our medical bits have stacked up because we've been poorly recently, so I'm just going to put that back in the first aid kit and then rotate the diffuser reeds, give a little spot clean, anti-bac, reload the toilet roll, get rid of any skidders, and then I'm just going to run the Hoover around quickly before putting a fresh bath mat down. That's looking much better. Clean the sink.
Okay, so boom, as you all can see, this client needs to be cleaned thoroughly, and we're gonna get right into it. Boom, this client did request a deep cleaning service, and as you all can see, I got her right on together. This is the living room, dining area, and kitchen. And next, we're going to go into two of the bathrooms that's in her home. This is the first bathroom. As you all can see, it's not in the best shape. But I did get her right on together. You know I did. Come on now. You know I got it together. Boom. The only way. Boom. Got it right on together. Now we're going to go into the next bathroom. And yeah. It's just, you know, you see it. And this is exactly how things are prior to my arrival. Boom. The thorough way or no way. Get into it.
Ava babysat for some of our sweet friends today, and instead of just dropping her off, I decided to stick around and deep clean this mama's sink for her. I remember what it was like to have three little ones in the house and how overwhelming it can feel. So I was really excited to do this small thing for such a wonderful mama. I didn't have my cleaning supplies with me, but I was able to make do with what she had on hand, and I ordered her a Rubbermaid reveal.
So my flatmates went home this weekend for Christmas, and this is the state the kitchen was in after a 10-week term. So I started off with disinfecting the bin with the flora and then some like sprayed disinfectant on the outside, and then I removed all of the sponges and dishmatics from around the sink to reveal this. I started by just using kitchen roll to get rid of all of this stuff. It was really wet as well, so it was just so grim. I had to wear gloves for it. The sink itself was really stained, and I saw on Facebook that Sif cream is really good for the stains, so I really got into it with a scrub mummy, and most of the stains did come out. Then I removed all of the sponges off the dishmatics because they really smelled like mildew, and then I wiped the table down. Moved all the appliances onto the table so I could scrub down the counter using the Sif cream. Once I had done the countertops, moved on to the hobs. I used the pink stuff for this. One of my flatmates likes to cook with a lot of oil and it splatters grease everywhere, and the pink stuff does a really, really good job of getting this all off. So I gave it a good scrub. Then I did the air vents above the ovens, and I had to go over the hobs a second time with the Sif cream, and the back wall as well was also really splattered with grease. Next, I did the appliances and then moved onto the wall behind the bin. Someone needs to learn how to aim when putting things in the bin, is all I'm gonna say. And then I vacuumed the floor and scrubbed the floor around the bin, which was also grim, and then I mopped the floor, and here's what we have now. Come back for part two where I do the ovens.
If, like me, you are not a fan of the Dyson cordless vacuum, you need to check out the Tinico. I've had mine almost 2 years, and I love it. It comes with two batteries that hold a charge very well, and all of the attachments you could possibly need. I love that you don't have to hold the power button down the whole time. It is also very powerful and easy to clean.
I got free rent for a month in my apartment because I texted my landlord and told her that these stairs were a safety hazard. I then told her that I'd wash them in exchange for a free month's rent, and she agreed. It only took me about an hour, and that month I saved all my rent money. You never know until you ask.
Okay, so these are all of my pads. They've already done a cold rinse. And just a reminder, every time I take a pad off, it goes into the menstrual bag. And then at the end of my period, they all get dumped in here as well as the menstrual bag. So once you do a cold rinse, we're going to go ahead and do a hot wash. So I use Persil. That's one of my favorite detergents. There's no softeners and it's super cleansing. And we just go ahead and put the detergent in. So this is the detergent I use. It also has the power of OxiClean and it's a deep clean. I also add laundry sanitizer by Lysol. There's no bleach in it and it kills all the bacteria. And the laundry sanitizer goes into the softener section. I also went ahead and added a little bit of powdered OxiClean. Okay, so that's all we're gonna do. I just do a normal wash. I just make sure my water is hot, the soil is either normal or heavy, and then just give it a start. And then once it's done, you can pull the bag out, let it air dry, and then throw your pads in the dryer and they are ready for your next period.
I'm going to show you one of the greatest sales techniques for any service business, and it's called blowing the symmetry. I got this from my buddy Aaron, and basically how you do it is if the customer's on the fence about your service, you clean a test spot for them, but you make sure that you do it in a place that they see every day, and you clean it so good that they can never unsee it again, because it's easy to live with something dirty when everything else around it is dirty, but when part of it is clean, it's almost impossible.
If you have a garbage disposal, do me a favor. Go pull out the cover and look what is underneath. Is yours as bad as mine? Let's clean it together. Start by dumping 2 cups of ice cubes and some salt in it. Turn on the disposal with a small stream of water until all the ice is gone. Then pour in about 1 cup of baking soda, then about 1/2 cup of vinegar, and let it bubble away. Use some Dawn Power Wash and your Rubbermaid Reveal to scrub away all of the grime. Make sure to unplug the garbage disposal before you start scrubbing down in there too much. Now run a sliced lemon through the disposal while running some water, and your garbage disposal will smell fresh as can be.
It's about to get nasty. Let's deep clean my sink. First, I go under the splash guard with a long handled scrubber because my splash guard doesn't remove. I get down in that drain and then I take off this thing. I have no idea what it's called, but look how nasty it is. I scrub it down good with a toothbrush and then come behind it with a little scrubber. And then after that, I take the top piece, which is disgusting as well, and put it in some citric acid. I then scrub down my sink with the Barkeeper's Friend, the powder version, and I do not let this stuff sit on my sink. I rinse it off immediately using a microfiber towel. It's just the easiest way to get it up quickly. Then it's time to clean this part of the faucet, and I stick that in citric acid as well. And look at this. Oh my god, this is why you need to be cleaning this as well. Do not skip this, okay? I stay stocked with toothbrushes because they come in so handy at times like this. After that's all clean, I apply Perfect Sink. Then I drop in my DIY garbage disposal drops. Look how the Perfect Sink repels water. And that's it, we're all done. Yes, bomb.
Because all of the pieces in this bath were larger, I simply drained the water and then picked up everything that was left. When I do a bath with smaller pieces, I'll put a strainer upside down over the drain to make sure they don't go down it. Once I cleaned out all of the bigger pieces, I got to work scrubbing the tub.
Oi, oi, gente, tudo bem com vocês? Eu espero que sim. Gente, desde o dia que essa máquina chegou em casa, a minha mãe está infernizando a minha vida para eu limpar o sofá dela. Então eu decidi fazer minha boa ação de final de ano, né, gente? Ver se o Papai Noel não esquece de fazer meu Pix, né? E ver aí que eu me comportei muito bem. Porque a gente casa, sai de casa achando que não vai obedecer, mas a mãe, tá boa, eu que não venho limpar esse sofá aqui não, pra ver se ela não passava com o trenó em cima de mim. O sofá da minha mãe, por ser cinza, ele engana bem, viu, gente, a sujeira. Você olhando assim, não parece que ele tá tão sujo quanto ele realmente estava. Dessa vez, eu usei um produto próprio, meu Deus, quase um trava-língua, pra limpar estofados, tá? Eu acho que eu já mostrei ele aqui. Se eu não mostrei, eu mostrei naquela outra rede social de vídeos lá, tá? E pra quem não acha limpa estofado, gente, usa um alvejante sem cloro. Fé no pai que dá certo. E respondendo a perguntas que vai ter, eu prevejo, gente, eu sou o próprio João Bidu. Essa máquina, gente, foi o valor de R$899, tá bom? Muito obrigado pela compreensão. Mas com certeza aí na loja do Velho da Ravan, em outras milhões de lojas, deve ter. Mais barato, mais caro, enfim. E não tem cupom não, tá? Porque a VAP não me notou. Mas é isso, até a próxima. Valeu, falou.
I always show you guys washing my sponges, but today we're gonna wash my brushes. Yes, I know, this is a ridiculous amount of makeup brushes. Got my sticky. Normally for soap, I like to use a cleansing bar, but I don't have one, so I'm gonna use this Dove soap. Hot water, give my brush a couple swirls. Then a good scrub on my mat. I've got one down, about 100.
You have all been so patient, and today I finally put the scrub daddy to the test. I wanted to wait until I had a really big mess to see how well it could tackle it. I started by getting the scrub daddy really wet with regular tap water, then sticking it in the freezer so it could get really hard while I prepared the stove. Once I removed the knobs and burners, I sprayed down the cooktop with my Dawn Power Wash. I pulled the hard scrub daddy out of the freezer and scrubbed down all the grime on the stove. Of course, I still use my Rubbermaid Reveal in some of the really tiny crevices. I then sprinkled down the cooktop with some baking soda and spritzed it with some vinegar. I use the scrub daddy to scrub this paste into the cooktop, then let it sit for 10 minutes. I then scrubbed away that mixture using the scrub daddy that I ran under hot water to make it soft and pliable. Once I wiped down all the mess, I sprayed the cooktop with some glass cleaner and buffed it out with a microfiber towel. I can't do much about the pre-existing damage on this stove, but I am incredibly impressed with the scrub daddy. It definitely gets the jet set stamp of approval.
Amazon Home Hack. Say goodbye to dustpans forever with this 2-in-1 cordless broom with a built-in vacuum. The broom is super lightweight and gets a full charge in less than a half hour. To activate the vacuum, simply press the nozzle to the ground and the vacuum creates a powerful and accurate suction. This gadget holds up to 1 cup of dust and debris and the eject button releases it straight into the trash.
Ever since we moved into this house, the garbage disposal has smelled so bad. I've tried my best to deep clean it several times, but the smell just would not go away. So tonight, I decided to take apart the plumbing and see if there was something else going on. I'm still not sure I got to the root of the problem, but the pipes were pretty bad, so I scrubbed them to the best of my ability and then put everything back together. Once the pipes were clean and put back into place, I filled the sink full of hot water and let it all run through the disposal. While you normally should only run cold water when you're running your disposal, when you're cleaning it, it's actually better to use hot water. But make sure you never use boiling water. Items you don't think you need, but you do. Part 1. This battery organizer is a must. And it comes with a tester in case you find random ones and you are not sure they work.
Grill Cleaning 101. Cooking Grids, Part 2. This video is to show you the after results from my first cooking grid video. To clarify, my job is owning and operating my own professional barbecue cleaning business. I clean grills every day for a living. How I clean my grills may be different from what you are used to seeing, but this is how I guarantee to all my clients that every crack and corner will be grease-free. And when you own an expensive grill, like this client's $2,000 Turbo STS, you don't want it staying dirty forever. And when a client's grill has stainless steel cooking grids, their transformation is the best part. Grill on.
Unicorns on my mind. What pill you want me to inhale, baby? I wanna make you want me. Boy, just scream.
One of our brand partners came to our house to interview us. Before they arrived, we did a quick polish of the house to make everything look nice and clean. While the video only shows me working, I promise everyone in the family was pitching in to help. Come watch as we get it all ready to go.
How often do you deep clean your drain? Do you have to deep clean your drain? Yes, you do have to deep clean your drain because we cook every day. We cook almost each and every day. So hence you need to deep clean your drain because of the smell. You sometimes will feel that when you get into the house, there's this smell that you don't know where is it coming from. It is coming from the drain. Hence you need to deep clean your drain each and every time. What do you use when you deep clean your drain? Use bicarbonate of soda, use white vinegar. What you add 3 tablespoon of bicarbonate of soda. You pour it into your drain. White vinegar, half a cup of white vinegar. You close it up for 10 minutes. You have to close it up for 10 minutes so that it drains all the oil, all the waters that we all sometimes every time use. After 10 minutes, you will then pour your boiled water on top of it. That is how you deep clean your drain.
Hey, all my cleaning mamas. So I have something I want to show you all. You know, we all love this Dawn Power Wash, right? Use it on everything, dishes, everything. Well, something that I've started doing, and I love the way it cleans. When this runs out, always keep your containers. I know you can buy refills, this and that, and get more Dawn Power Wash, but they are wonderful to make a mixture in to clean your bathrooms, your countertops, little messes that need cleaning up. So I fill it up with water to about right here. And then I just take good old Dawn, because we know it cuts through grease, it cleans all kinds of stuff, it's antibacterial if you get the right kind, everything. I love that stuff. So I pour a little bit of Dawn in here. Let me get in the frame. I pour a little bit of Dawn in here. I always start with my water in here first, because if you pour your stuff in there and then do the water, it's like, you know, your sink, it suds up and you don't get as much in there. And then I'm obsessed with Fabuloso. I always have been. This is one of my favorite scents. So then I finish filling it up. Let's see if it's in here. With Fabuloso. All the way up. And then I take my lid, pop it back on, give it a shake, and it makes the best cleaner that you'll ever use. I almost forgot to say this. I always write on the top my mix, because I don't want to get it mixed up with what I'm using to clean my dishes with. So I just write that on there, and then every time I look under the sink, I can grab it and go clean the mess. Thanks. Have a blessed day.
Today, we are testing Black Diamond Grout Cleaner. You start by spraying it in all of your grout lines, then let it sit for 1 to 3 minutes. After it's done sitting, come back in and scrub out all of the dirt. Of course, for this, I like to use the Rubbermaid Reveal with a grout head on it. Once you've scrubbed out all of the dirt, come back in and wipe it clean using a wet rag. Wipe the surface as many times as needed until your rag comes out clean. So the pros, it did an amazing job. The grout lines looked really clean afterward. The cons, it had a very strong chemical smell that I could hardly handle. Overall, I would probably give it a 7 out of a 10.
I glued the tiles down for y'all. ITK, why you guys think this is a bathroom, but it's an entryway to outside, the mudroom, and the upstairs apartment. This is my mother's house. She doesn't want anything replaced. She doesn't want me to clean. I do it for fun and for it to be cleaned. I'm only staying here a little while to save some money. My mother doesn't want me wasting any on her house.
I found this 56-year-old jet fuel while digging up a crashed jet that I found in the woods, and I could not get it off my hands to save my life. You guys tagged Grip Clean about 1,000 times in one of my videos, and they came through and sent me a care package. In return, I sent them some of the jet fuel to make a video with, and it passed their test with flying colors. I wasn't quite satisfied, though, because I needed to know if I could do it blindfolded. By the way, these things smell absolutely incredible. After about 30 seconds, I pulled the blindfold off and was genuinely shocked by how well it worked. I missed a couple spots because I was blindfolded, but about 5 seconds later, they were completely gone. Thank you, Grip Clean, for not just having an incredible product, but also being a fun and friendly company.
Do you have a slow draining shower? This $5 kit from Amazon may be the perfect solution. Isley's shower in the new rental was hardly draining, and I was able to pull out all of this gunk. If you decide to do this, duet me and let's see who pulls out the worst stuff. Judging by the messiness of my kitchen this morning, I think it's safe to say we had a lot of fun last night. We had over 30 people in our home, and while we did straighten up a little bit before we went to bed, I gave myself permission to enjoy our company and get a decent night's sleep before I cleaned everything up. If you struggle with cleaning tasks, rather than beating yourself up and feeling discouraged that you haven't tackled them yet, give yourself some grace. Tell yourself it's okay to let it sit for a minute until you're ready to attack it, then set a timer and give it your all. If you implement this strategy into your cleaning routine, over time, it will not only shift the way you view cleaning, but the way that you view yourself. Do you really need to deep clean your washing machine? Isn't its job to clean things? As you can clearly see here, if you don't take the time to regularly clean out your machine, dirt, grime, and hard water can build up, affecting the performance of it. I sprayed down the entire thing with a mixture of Dawn and vinegar in a Dawn Power Wash container, then scrubbed it using my Rubbermaid Reveal. This mixture was not working on the hard water stains, so I added some rust remover to the scouring head of the Reveal, and it took it right off. Once I was done scrubbing, I wiped everything out the best I could, then ran the washer on the hottest cycle it had. While that cycle was running, I wiped down the entire exterior of the machine using my Dawn and vinegar combination. Once the washer was done, I ran another cycle, still using hot water and adding 2 cups of vinegar. Once the tub was full, I used that water to rinse everything one last time, leaving it as clean as possible.
How do Asians clean their bathrooms?
Do you have a glass cooktop? If so, you may find this video helpful. My sister-in-law asked if I could come help her as she had some really hard stains on her cooktop that she could not get off with the pink stuff alone. We started off by putting the pink stuff on one burner and the barkeeper's friend cream cleaner on the other. We scrubbed both burners with the Rubbermaid Reveal, and while barkeeper's friend did a better job than pink stuff, we still weren't happy with the results. So we applied just the barkeeper's friend, and that did the trick. We used a razor blade on the really tough areas, and that back burner that had some rust took several tries, but we finally got it all off. Once the spots were gone, we cleaned it with Dawn Power Wash, then applied some car wax so that next time it'll be much easier for her to clean. It looks like an almost brand new stove. She was so happy.
Let's test it out on a carpet sample. Pour it on. It's just soaking in. Can't even scrape it off. Got this little bit off. Put the rest back in the burner. 10/10 do not recommend.
Y aquí está cómo limpiar ese desastre. Primer paso, máscara. Luego empezamos a sacar todo lo que está dentro, que por cierto era muchísima comida y mucha de ella podrida. Como ya saben, me acabo de hacer mis uñitas y así que guantes dobles porque no me las arruino por nada. Toda la comida que sacamos y así se va viendo el refri ya vacío. Un pequeño desastre por acá de algo que se cayó y por supuesto amigos desagradables. No apto para personas delicadas. Ya con cepillo en mano y una mezcla de agua desengrasante y jabón para lavar empezamos a restregar y vamos retirando todos los residuos con papel. Todo para afuera y así va quedando. Por supuesto restregamos bien con nuestra esponjita y jabón y retiramos toda la espuma para al final desinfectar con Clorox.
when I think about you, and my heart starts to warm, it's like a bomb.
My parents are staying with me for Christmas. They're gonna be here in 30 minutes, but I wanna make their guest bathroom feel like a hotel. First, I should probably wipe down the counters. Counters are immaculate. Mirrors, not so much. Let's get them cleaned. This thing broken? Oh my God. It's gonna give me so much hate, but I literally don't have time. Bad. I'm stressed. I didn't have time to think of solutions. The mirror is done, and that's all that matters. Let's work on this. His and hers deodorant. Shaving essentials. Mouthwash. Body mist. Hand cream. Dry shampoo. Hairspray. Girly essentials. My mom's lips are always chapped, so I wanted to give her some options. She's gonna be excited about this one. Hand soaps for each of their sides. Candles to set the mood. I wanna spoil my mom with some amazing skincare. My favorite moisturizer. Hair ties. Got them each their own body wash. Christmas toilet paper. Everyone knows it goes like this. Festive washcloths. Festive hand towel. Should I steam them? Who am I kidding? I don't have time for that. His side is set, now my mom's. And a festive Christmas rug for the final touch.
So cute.
My parents have done so much for me over the years. This is literally the